A plus B. This here is an expression. It's a mathematical expression. I'm sure you've already seen it before. It's like 1 plus 2, 5 plus 3. There are expressions. In this case, it's an expression. It's an int expression. Why? Because a number plus another number gives us a result another number. What we are saying in this expression is the assignment of C of A plus B. What is Java going to do? It's going to sum what is inside A. A, 1. What is inside B? A, 2. What gives us a result of 3? And it keeps it in 3. We're going to put here C. If everything is okay, first it should print a 1 and afterwards a 2. Then a 3 for C, which keeps a 3. And lastly, the fin, the end. Let's see what happens. 1, 2, 3. With this, I was trying to teach you the definition of a variable. This. What we're telling Java is to please keep a space. Labeled with A, where we can keep an integer number. In the second line, we are telling Java to keep in the space labeled with A or 1. Here, we are telling two things at the same time. Please create a space in the memory, an int variable labeled with B, and inside we keep a 2. Lastly, we ask Java to reserve a space in the memory for an int variable labeled with C. And we tell him to put into C A plus B. Afterwards, we ask Java to print A, which is worth 1, print B, and print C. We have learned expressions. This is an expression. We have learned one type, int, the definition of variables, and the assignment. We're also going to learn how to define a variable of another type. Let's define a string. A string type variable. In this case, a string type variable named s. And we're going to assign to s a word. Hola, mundo. Hello, world. A string is any type of character in between quotation marks. The quotation marks are to tell Java that it doesn't have to interpret it. It's a character and it doesn't have to understand it. If there wasn't any quotation marks, Java could think it's a variable identifier or something else, and it would try to interpret it. But with the quotation marks, we're telling Java that it's a word and it doesn't have to interpret it. Here we have an instruction which creates the variable and another instruction to assign. We could also have done this, which is just the same thing. An instruction which does two things, creates the variable and assigns this value to the variable. And here we can write. We can write on the console the content of the variable s. Let's print again. And we can see hola mundo, hello world. The content of the variable a, b, c, and fin, the end. To make it a bit shorter, we're going to change this one too. And we could also do this. This doesn't change the meaning of the problem. We have made the definition and assignment in one. Here, in S. We can create. Let's create string, for example, palabra dos, word two, and I assign to palabra two ciao and semicolon. This is something I've been using all the time. Notice that I put semicolons. Semicolon separates instructions. Every instruction, every order we give in Java has to be separated by semicolon. Java doesn't mind if one is on top of another. This works this way or this other way. It does just the same. Java doesn't mind the returns. We usually put it into different lines to avoid confusion, to have it in order. But for Java, an instruction starts and ends, well, it ends with a semicolon. It reads, and when it sees a semicolon, it knows that it's the end of an instruction. It goes on reading, and the same with the second and third instruction. Okay, I've created a variable s and a new variable palabra dos. Here, I didn't use only a letter, but a word for the variable, for the label of the variable. I did it on purpose so that you can see you can choose the name of the variable arbitrarily. Well, not so arbitrarily. A word has to always begin with a letter. See, I get an error. Syntax error on token 2. Delete this token. The labels have to always begin with a letter. After, you can put a number if you want. It can also have a hyphen. Let's try with median hyphen 2, I think. Let's do the test. No. Median hyphen, no. Low hyphen, yes, and some other signs. Okay, we have just created another variable. Now we are going to try to create an expression. String resultado, it's result. Assignment s plus palabra two, dos. In resultado, I'm going to keep s plus palabra two and I'm going to print on the console. Siso resultado. If you notice, I write RE and control space and Eclipse tries to guess what I'm trying to write. In this case, resultado. Okay, let's analyze what I did. The variable s was already created and we had put inside hola mundo. The variable palabra dos, string type, had already been created too. And we had put into it ciao. Here is the new thing. We have created a string type variable named resultado and we had assigned it to s plus palabra 2. S is hola mundo and palabra 2 is chao. This plus has always been used to add numbers. But how does a plus work when we are talking about words? They didn't tell us about this at school. The plus in Java is to concatenate things. It means to stick. Two words, this word here, is going to be stuck with this word here. If this is true, when I run this and we print resultado, result, the first system.out here before hola mundo, before this S, hola mundo chao should appear. Let's see. Yes, hola mundo chao. Notice that I stuck it together without any space. Hola mundo chao. Java doesn't notice that there is what there is inside the string. For Java, it's okay to be stuck together without a space. The quotation marks make Java treat everything in the same way. If we want a space here, we're going to have to do it ourselves. At the end of hola mundo, we can put a space. Run and see. That here we have hola mundo chao with a space in between. In the variable resultado string type, we wrote hola mundo stuck to chao. I'm going slowly for the people who haven't seen this before. Maybe somebody is getting bored. If you're getting bored, be a bit patient, or if not, go to the next tutorial. I hope I'm not going too quickly for the people who are seeing this for the first time. With this tutorial I'm satisfied because I have shown you what a variable is, how a variable is created or defined. As we had seen, you just need to write type, space and name of the variable. We have learned how to assign a value to a variable, For example, s, we assign s this word, hola mundo. String type, the string type is really more than a word. It's like a group of letters. Well, not even letters. We're talking of characters. This space here is kept as a space. A group of characters are kept in S. We have also learned about types. Variables are of different types. We've seen two types really, string for words and int for numbers. We have learned about expressions. This is a type int expression. We add one int to another int and the result is an int which is kept in another variable. And here we have a string type expression. We add a string. To another string. Well, we don't really add it, we concatenate it. And the result, which will be another string, is kept in another position of a memory, another variable, resultado, and we print it afterwards. Okay, I think for now, I think for this tutorial is enough. I hope these three concepts are clear for you now. I hope it's useful, and see you in the next tutorial.